your hand right here. There you go. Can you see me?
Yes.
Hi there, hello. You see me? Hi there, my brainwashed. So this is Josh with Heritage coming at you today. Hi, how you doing? Today, Virtue is going to be my camera woman, so this is going to be interesting. So if I'm cut off at the head or I'm not in the center of the picture, I'm going to move right and see if she follows me. Scan. Scan. There you go. You found me? All right, I'm going to go this way. Can you follow me? All right. Today, what I'm going to talk about is circumcision, because you guys have been asking me about circumcision, and I've been requested to do a video on circumcision, so I'm going to do it. So what I did is I looked it up online, and this is what I found. In Romans 2, okay, Romans 2, it says, 25, "For circumcision verily profiteth, but if thou keepeth the law, but if thou be a breaker of the law, thy circumcision shall be made uncircumcision. Therefore, if the uncircumcision keep the righteousness of the law, shall not his uncircumcision be counted for circumcision?" Okay? "And shall not uncircumcision, which is by nature, if it fulfill the law, judge thee, who by the letter and circumcision dost transgress the law? For if he is not a Jew, which is one outwardly, neither is that circumcision which is outwardly in the flesh. But he is a Jew, which is one inwardly, and the circumcision is that of the heart and in the spirit, and not in the letter, whose praise is not of men, but of God." So this is what I'm talking, this is what it says, okay? So basically, if you are a Jew, it's fine. Be a Jew, be circumcised. But what's more important is circumcision of the heart, okay? If you are a Gentile, you are fine to be uncircumcised. Because what is important is doing the law, not having your top of your... Because if you are circumcised, you can be unrighteous and it doesn't do anything for you. And if you are righteous and you're not circumcised, you are righteous. Circumcision is irrelevant about your righteousness. And so now we have, and if going to Romans 3 and it says, "What advantage then hath the Jew, what profit is there of circumcision? Seeing one is God, which shall justify the circumcision by faith and the uncircumcision through faith." So it's not by cutting off of flesh. It's by faith. It's by doing what the Word says. If you're a Gentile, you don't need to be circumcised. It has been amended. In the New Testament, it has been amended. We are not Jews. We are Gentiles. I was born a Gentile. The vast majority of you out there in the internets are also Gentiles. So let's stop trying to chop it, okay? If you're a Jew, that's more power to you. Yes, that's you're a Jew, you're chosen, chop it off, that's fine. That's not for me to judge. What does matter is righteousness' sake. If I believe the Word of God, then, and I do the Word of God, then I am righteous and it has no bearing. So, I just want to bring that up to you because I've been having questions. This is Virtue's first time behind the camera, so let's give her a big round of applause. Yay, Virtue! So, I'm the Heretic. It's been a lot of fun, and I hope this turns out well. Peace, love, and grooviness. What's up?
Done. I did it.
And what is up your bum today, Mr. Grampus?
You are so silly, Mommy!
Huh?
You're so silly!
I'm not the one with a towel on my head.
Hey, I need to put this towel! Ah, please help me!
Yeah. Is that what you usually do for Mama? Whine.
I need to hide.